बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ 12th लेक्चर ऑफ रिसर्च मेथडोलॉजी। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ साइंटिफिक वर्कप्लेस, सैम्पल थीसिस राइटिंग, सैम्पल रिसर्च पेपर राइटिंग, सेविंग, क्लोजिंग एंड ओपनिंग द न्यू डॉक्यूमेंट, ओपनिंग अ सैम्पल डॉक्यूमेंट etc. In this lecture, we will study entering and editing mathematics in the scientific workplace, formatting the document with tags, formatting the document with labels, and typesetting the document. So, first of all, we see how we can write mathematics in scientific workplace. The shortcut key for writing the mathematics is Control plus M. We have to press Control and M simultaneously. The shortcut key to write the subscript is Control 4. The shortcut key for the superscript is Control plus 3, and to write an equation in the center of the document or in paragraph, the shortcut key is Control D. The shortcut key to write fraction is Control F. And moreover, different kinds of samples are available in the sample cache, from which we can use the symbols to write mathematics. Now we see how these shortcut keys work practically. I open a sample thesis. So this is the sample thesis which I use to give my students to write their thesis. This is written the acknowledgments, and this tag is for page numbering. The page numbering style is Roman, and page style is plain. This command is used to use the acknowledgement in the table of contents. This is the abstract of the thesis, and this command is used to include the abstract in the table of contents. So this command is written add content line TOC table of contents chapter and then abstract. This command is to display the table of contents. So when you compile this document into PDF file, this will show the table of contents. So when I click on this icon, this button typeset PDF preview, you will see the output in this form. This is acknowledgement, and this is abstract, and then this is the table of contents, which shows different sections and their page numbers. Okay, how to write the heading of a chapter? So this is the heading of chapter, which is in large blue color. If I select this text and click on the body text from this tag toolbar, this will be a simple body text. So if I want to convert into some section or chapter heading, I will click again on the tag toolbar. There are different types of tags. There is a body text, body verbatim, centered, chapter head, long quotation, part head, section head, short quotation, subsection head. So from this list we can choose any text to make it heading of a chapter or a section. So I make this text the chapter heading, so it becomes large blue color, and this is the heading of the chapter as we can see in the PDF file. So this is the chapter heading, and this is written by the workplace itself, chapter 1 and introduction. One thing I want to tell you that the chapter numbering, the section numbering, equation numbering and reference numbering is given by the workplace itself. We do not need to give numbers to sections and to equations. We just label the equations, we just label the sections, and we just label the definitions, etc. And the numbering is given by the workplace itself. Now we see that we can bold the text by selecting this text. I can bold it from this tag by clicking bold. The text is bold. Again, if you want to make it normal, we will click on normal text. There are several types of formats and styles to change the font: bold, italic, large, normal size, small, etc. From this pop-up menu, you can write section, chapter heading, subsection heading, etc. As you see, this is the section heading of the section. And if you want to convert this into chapter head, you will click on the chapter head. This line will be converted to the chapter heading. If you want to change this line into simple text, you will click on body text. If you want to convert this text into section heading, you will choose the section head. So in this way, we label the headings and chapter headings, subsection heading, etc. So in the first pop-up menu of tag toolbar, you will see different types of tags. This is acknowledgement tag, algorithm, axiom, bibliography item, which is used to write references, bullet list item, case, claim, conclusion, conjecture, corollary, definition, description list item, example, exercise, lemma, number list item, problem, proof, proposition, remark, theorem, etc. You can use different types of tags to write whatever you want. So I give you the example of writing definition in your thesis. So if you choose the tag of definition, for example, I want to write the definition of nonlinear equation. So I choose the definition tag from the list of tags and then write the text of the definition. So in this way we write the definition. And now if you press the enter button, the next tag for the definition automatically appears, and you can write the definition number 2 of your thesis. For example, this is the definition of error. So if you want to remove the tag, you will click on this remove tag button, which is in green arrow, green left arrow. So when you click on this button, the tag will be removed. So now we are again in the simple body text. Now we see how we can write the equations. One thing, dear students, you should note that we are not giving the number to the definition, we are not giving number to the sections and chapters. This will be automatically given in the PDF file when we typeset the workplace file into PDF file. This, the numbering will be shown in the PDF file. Now we see how we can write the mathematics in the text. So if you want to write mathematics in the text, you will press Ctrl M and the style of text will be converted to mathematics, and the color of the text will be red. For example, here I want to write the mathematics. I press Ctrl M. and the color of the text is red now, and I can write here any equation. If you want to write text again, you will press Ctrl M again, and this mathematics will be converted into text. So in this way we write mathematics in the text. But if you want to write the equation in the center of the document, you will press Ctrl D. When you press Ctrl D, a box is appeared in the center of the document, and here you can write any equation which you want. I already have told you that the shortcut key of writing subscript is Ctrl 3, for superscript is Ctrl 4. The shortcut key to write the equation in the center is Ctrl D. The shortcut key of fraction is Ctrl F. So I here write the equation dy by dx minus y square plus xy is equal to 0. So in this way I can write the equation. Now if we want to label this equation, and in the text if we want to cite this equation and we want to use this equation, we have to write the number, or we have to write the label, we have to assign this equation a label. So I double click on the right side of this equation, a box of display properties of the equation will appear, and we have to choose auto number, and here we will label, we will assign the label to the equation, or simply key to the equation. So I label here eq1, I label eq1 to this equation and press OK. So this button shows the label of the equation, which is eq1. Now we can use this equation, or we can cite or refer this equation in the text by pressing the cross reference button. This is the cross reference button. We will click on this button and a box to write the cross reference, to write the key of the equation will appear. The key of equation is eq1, so we will write here the key of equation eq1 and press OK. And the label or the reference of the equation has been written here. In this way we refer the equation in the text. If you write multiple equations in the text, you will press Ctrl D, write first equation, then at the end of the equation you will press Enter, then you can write the second equation. Again, if you want to write another equation in the same box, you will press Enter. So these are three lines of the system of three equations. Now if you want to give a label to these equations, you will again double click on the right side of this set of equations, and there appears a box where we will choose auto number. Now we will assign each line a unique label. So there are three lines to these system of equations, so we choose separate line number or separate key for the line. So here I choose A1 for line number 1. For line number 2 I choose A2. For line number 3 I choose A3. In this way we assign separate label to each equation in each line. So this is the way to write equations and to label the equations. So dear students, this is the end of today's lecture. In this lecture we have discussed about writing the mathematics in the scientific workplace, the shortcut key of writing mathematics, Control M, the shortcut keys for subscript, superscript, and writing the fraction, writing the equation in the center of the document, and labeling the equations and referencing the equations. We have also discussed to format the text in the document. For example, if you want to bold the text, italic, large, if you want to make the headings, or if you want to write definition, theorem, proofs, lemmas, etc. And we have studied about the typesetting the document. In the next lecture, we will discuss cross-references, creating bibliographies and references and citations, and some other keyboard shortcuts. Take care of yourself and your family. Allah Hafiz.